So welcome, one and all, to another episode of SAP Code Talk. I'm DJ, your host this time, and today we have yet another special guest, Christian Leschner, and Christian is going to be talking to us about Terraform, the Terraform provider for SAP Business Technology Platform. So thank you for joining us, Christian, and welcome.
It's a pleasure. Thanks for having me.
I'm super interested to find out more about this. For folks who have been thinking about this space for a while, they may know you may know that we've already done some work generally in this area. But really, I started to look at Terraform when I spoke to Christian and Rui and co. And the phrase that comes to mind is Terraform is an infrastructure as code tool. So, Christian, maybe we can start by you explaining what is that all about?
Yeah, sure. So infrastructure as code is kind of the umbrella term for everything that is about managing your infrastructure via code. So it's about provisioning infrastructure and managing the infrastructure. And the way you do it is you put some piece of code somewhere, and that is basically following, I would say, two main paradigms. And one is that this piece of code is not telling the tooling how to achieve what you want with your infrastructure. So telling them, create first this, then that, and for doing so, do this and do that. But it's really declarative. It's telling, hey, this is the target state that I would have. And let's take BTP as an example. This is the sub account, this is the entitlements, and so on and so forth. This is what I want to have. How you do that, your tooling, I do not care at all. Just do it. And the second point is, that's kind of connected to this target state, is this state then also gets persisted. And usually it's persisted somewhere centrally so that you can collaborate on the setup. And this is kind of the holy grail for any infrastructure as code tool to have that centrally stored.
Cool. Okay. I mean, this sort of reminds me, we're going slightly off piece here already, but this slightly reminds me of Kubernetes, right? Is that, is my brain in the right area when I try to think of something I already know a little bit about in this sense?
So that's a hot topic. So Kubernetes, I would say, and the concepts behind Kubernetes with the declarative definition and the operators and so on, might be even one step further. But the idea is the same. So you define your target state, your manifests, and then you apply them via an API. And basically, it's the same with Terraform or with any infrastructure as code tooling. Having said that, it's not fully declarative Terraform. So you can have some imperative logic in there, which makes your life easier, like loops or something like that.
Interesting. So yeah, this concept, this declarative concept, and just make it happen. You know, I'm sure I'm thinking of Jean-Luc Picard there. I guess this is quite a common thing these days. So are there different implementations of this sort of infrastructure as code?
So there are different offerings. On the one hand side, of course, the let's say proprietary ones from the cloud vendors. So for example, Azure has Bicep as a language in order to achieve that. But there are also other vendors, as we already talked, HashiCorp Terraform. There is Pulumi, for example, which is a kind of a different approach, but quite interesting for developers. Mm-hmm. But there are all following those paradigms, and how they achieve that might be a bit different.
Gotcha. And then from these different implementations, what is the one that SAP went for and why?
So you already did the spoiler, right? Terraform, surprise. So we looked at the ecosystem, and of course that we could have done a proprietary solution. Maybe that's what you expected from SAP, but the topic is soft, right? So there are established solutions out there, and we looked at most of them, and we decided to go with the, I would say, de facto industry standard, which is HashiCorp Terraform. This is kind of widely used across the industry, And one big advantage of Terraform is that it enables kind of a so-called multi-provider approach. So Terraform is built around providers. That's what we also deliver, which are kind of, you can think of the glue between your declarative definition and what is happening on the platform. And you can combine different bits and pieces and providers. So you can combine that from Microsoft with SAP, with something that even running on premise, and make end-to-end stories happen. And that's why we decide, that's not the only reason, but that's one main reason why we decided to go for Terraform.
Excellent, excellent. That sounds like a very sensible approach. And also de facto industry standard, that sounds like music to my ears, exactly. So BTP is quite a broad platform. Can you tell me about, you know, which parts of SAP BTP are actually covered by the Terraform provider here?
Yeah. So taking a look under the hood of the provider, we are reusing parts of the BTP CLI. So what we cover is basically the same resources that the BTP CLI covers. So if you know the BTP CLI and you know what's in there, you know what we are able to do, at least mostly. So we do not cover everything because some commands in the BTP CLI are more CLI-ish, which yes, make no sense in this resource-based configuration of a system. But we try to cover most of the stuff that you probably need, at least what we heard from our customers. So that's kind of what we focus on. Now, if you are on more diving into BTP, you know, one moment, there is Cloud Foundry, there is Schema, this Kubernetes thingy. This is where the multi-provider topic comes into play. Nice. So for example, there is a Kubernetes provider that is, I think, maintained by HashiCorp themselves, if I'm not mistaken, which you can plug in and do the Schema stuff. There is a Cloud Foundry provider by the so-called Cloud Foundry community that you can use. There are some glitches and some rough edges there. So expect something to happen in that area soon.
But I guess the nice thing about the architecture of what we're talking about is that, all right, there might be some glitches in one particular provider, but is that it is therefore replaceable by something eventually, right? So, yep. You know, it's not as if you're stuck with something that's, you know, cast in concrete. That's great.
Yep. Right. Yep.
So I'm already excited about, you know, having a look at this. So how can customers, you know, basically get their hands on and start interacting with this Terraform provider? Is there, you know, is there something to buy or to subscribe to?
Now, this is quite unusual. There is nothing to buy. shocking moment. The provider per se that we deliver and that basically every other company delivers, I think there are now 3,000 providers available for Terraform. They are all free of charge. They are open source with a, I would say, enterprise-friendly open source license, Apache 2, usually.
Mm-hmm.
This is something that you can get that. Then you have to have the Terraform CLI in order to execute the stuff. Yeah. That's also free, so that there is no sign-up, no nothing. If you use it productively or not, doesn't matter. And, of course, for crafting the resources, you should have an editor like VS Code, which then also comes with extensions to help you with that. And maybe a BTP sub account or account in general might be helpful to deploy resources somewhere.
Yeah.
Having said that, we have no restriction with respect to trial. So you can make your hands dirty with or starting experimenting with a trial account.
I mean, it sounds like the perfect sweet spot, right? So you don't need to buy anything. It's open source. You can use a trial account on SAP BTP, you know, and also there's a CLI. You know, what else do you want, folks? It's amazing, right? So perfect opportunity to get started. But what happens if you have questions? You know, is there a place to, you know, file issues or feature requests or even just, you know, chat about the stuff?
Mm-hmm. So as it's an open source project, there is a well-defined way how to interact with us, and that's GitHub. So we have the provider available on GitHub, and this is also the one and only contact point that you have with us. You can open issues there for bugs. You can open issues there for feature requests. And you can also discuss with us. So within GitHub, I don't know if everybody's aware of that, there is a functionality half a year old or even a bit older, that's discussions.
Yeah.
Which allow you to have kind of a forum like experienced within the GitHub repo.
Yeah.
And we leverage all of that. And that's kind of how you can interact with us. And yeah, highly appreciate it if you do that, if you give feedback, if you have feature requests. One more thing. Also, the milestones are there on the GitHub repository.
Ah, awesome. Yeah.
So we, and now you might say, sure, you have it on the GitHub repository and you have a second GitHub repository internally, right? And then you kind of do things there. There is no hidden agenda. So we do not have any SAP internal stuff. It's all happening in this repository. Yeah. No hidden agenda, no hidden repository or something like that. Everything we do and every error that we bring in maybe is completely visible to you and to us.
I mean, that's music to my ears, and I'm sure it's music to all the listeners' ears as well. This is the way to work, right? Work openly, open source, in, again, on GitHub, which I think you could argue is also, you know, a de facto industry standard for how folks work on software together.
Absolutely. And it's fun. So yeah, we have all the CI/CD stuff and GitHub Actions, yeah. And it's just working.
Yeah, it's an incredible platform. So I think some folks might be aware, maybe not many, but there has been a license change in with Terraform. I mean, is there any impact from this license change? And sort of in the same breath, what about OpenTofu? Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Oh, that's quite some topic. So yeah, as you see, when you use Terraform, there is a company standing behind that, and that's HashiCorp. And HashiCorp did everything in an open source manner, and then, as open source sometimes goes sideways, they decided to change the licensing. Now we have to split that up. Mm-hmm. One part is the provider that we implement, and all the Golang libraries that we use in that are provided by HashiCorp. They are still under Apache 2.0 license or MIT license. So fine. Yeah. Where they changed the licensing is with the Terraform CLI. Now you might say, hey, this guy just said, we downloaded and everything's good, and now he's coming around with this license topic. Usually, if you are using Terraform as a customer, there is no impact for you as long as you do not get into competition with HashiCorp.
Yes.
So if you are offering a HashiCorp-like Terraform Cloud service, you have an issue with this license. If you're using the setup, as you usually do, to set up your BTP, your Azure, your AWS, no issues. Now, I'm not the lawyer. There is an excellent FAQ available on the HashiCorp website. Check that out. It's really well written. It's updated regularly. And that should answer your question. So. Big disclaimer from my side. Usually you have the slide at SAP, which says everything that I say is a lie.
Yeah.
This is the place where it should stick. Now you mentioned OpenTofu. I mean, due to this license change, the community folks, especially those who are in competition with HashiCorp, decided to do a fork. Mm-hmm. That's called OpenTofu now. And they are, they have released their first GA version at the beginning of this year. And we are in exchange with them. They are really open folks. And we also did some compatibility checks. And the point is, yes, our provider also works with OpenTofu. Having said that, we do not officially support OpenTofu as of today.
Right.
So if you think that the OpenTofu is something that you would like to use within your enterprise and there is some demand, please.
Yeah.
Use the GitHub repository, tell it to us, and then we can react. I think there are some cool stuff coming up with the upcoming OpenTofu release that might make OpenTofu quite tempting for companies. But let's see. So up to now, the feedback was not, you have to do that, but it was, we use Terraform.
Yeah, yeah. No, that makes total sense, right? So folks, I mean, I'm very privileged to know the folks in the team that's behind this Terraform provider for SAP BTP at SAP, including, you know, a team that includes Christian, they're also people. And, you know, Christian is being absolutely genuine when he says they're looking for your interaction, your feedback, your issues, your feature requests, questions. That's the whole point of working openly like this. So I can't emphasize enough how important this is, right, for you to, you know, give this team feedback. Absolutely. So last question, because we're almost out of time. What's next?
Yeah, so you already made the perfect segue. So we are working on what you wish, basically, what makes sense for you, what adds value to you. So I think the last two releases have been purely focusing on feature requests from the community. And we will work on that. Now, having said that, there are two bigger topics that we are looking into. One is, usually you have a BTP already set up. Mm-hmm. Now, how do I bring that stuff under the management of Terraform?
Yeah, how do you not? Yeah.
That's possible as of today. HashiCorp Terraform supports that, but that's super cumbersome. So that's really work that you have to do, and we would love to make that easier for you. And we call that's a working title, BTP Terraform Exporter, which would allow you to say this subaccount, take it, export it to Terraform, full stop. Yeah. But that's a huge topic, and that will evolve over this year. And as I already said, watch out in the SAP organization on GitHub if there might be popping up a second provider which might have something to do with an environment called Cloud Foundry. Maybe there is something coming up. Maybe. Who knows?
Exactly. Who knows? I mean, the team is finite and there are important things to work on. And I think that these two big topics that you mentioned are incredibly important. And I think there's going to be a lot of folks interested in working out how to go from zero to using Terraform with their existing BTP account. So the Terraform Exporter sounds super, super interesting, as does, of course, the replacement Cloud Foundry provider. So it just goes for me to say thanks so much to you, Christian, for coming on and telling us about the Terraform provider for SAP BTP. And thanks to you folks for listening. So it's goodbye from me.
Thanks a lot for having me, and stay safe. Bye.